Clinical researchers, how's it going? In preparation for my upcoming book, soon to be released, it's basically a comprehensive guide to clinical research. We're working hard on it, and the accompanying audiobook, which will be like almost another book in and of itself. I wanted to talk to you about how GCP got formed. Like, what were the foundations for GCP and ICH-GCP, which is ICH stands for the International Conference of Harmonization, and then Good Clinical Practices, GCP. It stemmed from three foundational things and moments in history, all right? The first one is the Nuremberg Code, which after World War II, when the Nazis were accused of atrocities on human experimentation in the concentration camps, Nuremberg Code came out after the war, basically said you can't do studies on people when you know that the outcome is going to be bad for them, and you can't just put someone in a study and not explain what the study is. Like, they have to be willing participants, all right? That's the first code, really, in modern history where they actually had guidelines for clinical research and human experimentation. The second one was the Declaration of Helsinki, and then I think it was 1964. Declaration of Helsinki really put the onus on physicians to do no harm to their subjects, to provide informed consent, to let them know, even though it wasn't formally letting them know, that comes later as I'm going to explain, but letting them know what the risk, benefits, side effects, all that stuff that has now become part of informed consent, letting subjects know that, doing no harm, making sure that the science is scientifically sound, right? And then the Belmont Report came in 1979, I believe, after the Tuskegee syphilis incident, which was a study on African-American males from the 1930s. It lasted for 40 years, where basically they enrolled, I think, 600 people, 400 who had syphilis, 200 who did not. They did not tell them they were joining a study. They just enrolled them in a study, and they said they were giving them treatment for bad blood. That was the exact words they used, what these researchers used. And they paid burial insurance for the subjects, who didn't know they were subjects, by the way, and they provided meals. So it was like completely taking advantage of vulnerable populations. So the Belmont Report came out in 1979, where you had to have a formal informed consent. You had to have IRB approving studies, an institutional review board approving the protocol. You had to obviously let subjects know they were in a study. You had to take extra precautions and measures for protecting vulnerable populations from joining studies. And you have to keep the benefits of being in a study for a patient has to outweigh any risks. And the problem with this, with the Tuskegee syphilis study, was that even when penicillin became approved in the 1940s for syphilis, they never gave any of the patients syphilis. They just studied them, which is, you know, nowadays no IRB would approve this, but that's what they did back then. So these are the three foundational pivotal moments in clinical research history. It's what is now the foundation of ICH-GCP. These are not... Now, some countries have these as laws. I know the Declaration of Helsinki is actually a law in some countries. In the United States, these are the foundations, these are the principles for good clinical practice, which the FDA holds all sites to these standards in the United States. So, very excited about this book coming out. It's going to be literally a comprehensive guide to everything. We're going to do a 4-hour video on this book, and very excited about this, but just thought, because I've never done a video on what allowed GCP to become what it is today. So hopefully this helps. Let me know if you have questions. Hopefully it's interesting. Study those three things: Nuremberg Code, Declaration of Helsinki and the Belmont Report for much more detail. I mean, we can go in greater detail on these things than we do in the book, but I'm trying to keep this video short. Right? Take care.